Hey, it's Vaz here from Aussie RC Playground, and welcome to another episode of RC Pit Stop. Today we're in the pits with the S-Works Zeus, and as you can see, I've fully built the car, and I'll probably cover off more of the build come review time, but a brief rundown is, you know, in regards to the build, it actually went together pretty easily. It wasn't the hardest thing to do. You know, I've built a couple of kits in the past, and you know, once you build your first couple, you're pretty much set to sort of go forth and conquer any type of build that you want, as long as, of course, the instruction manual has all the relative information in there. Now, I will say there were a couple of great areas in here, just in regards to the entire setup. One of them that I noticed was that they actually tell you to mount these camber links on the outermost hole, but if you do that, the wheels kind of tilt all the way out, so you've got to go into the middle hole. So that was one area that I found that you know, was a little bit wrong in the manual. There's also an addendum in here where they give you this separate sheet to follow these different instructions, and when you get to that section, you'll know about it. But aside from that, you know, it wasn't too bad. You kind of have to keep your wits about you. There are, like I said, there are a couple of little gray areas in the manual that you need to sort of look out for, but nothing that no one can handle, you know, as long as you're fairly careful when you're doing this build. But that's pretty much it as far as the build goes. Now today we're going to be installing the electrics, of course, and I'm going to be painting up the body. I was going to do some like elaborate paint scheme on the body, but I'll be honest, the body feels a little bit flimsy. It doesn't feel like it's going to be the most robust body on this. And for me to go through all that trouble of masking and cutting and all this, only to have the body completely wrecked after the first couple of upside down landings, I'm probably not going to be too satisfied with that, given the amount of work that I'm going to put into it. So I'm going to leave it with just one plain color. I'm going to let the stickers do the work and sort of decorate the body up a little bit, and I'll leave it at that. That's going to be the end of the story there. So you'll see the entire truck all finished up today, no doubt about that. Now, electrics. What did I select for this beast? Well, motor and ESC, of course, I had to go and get Hobbywing. And I've got the XE-Run brushless combo. Now, this is a 2250 kV combo, which comes with the XR8, comes with the XR8 Plus ESC, which is 150 amp. And of course, you got your 2250 kV, 4274 sensored brushless motor. So this is a sensored setup. And it should work brilliantly on this car. Now, I have been warned by those of you out there who already have one of these cars that the diff gearing on this is actually quite high. So it's kind of like a buggy gearing where it's designed to be, you know, with smaller wheels. So when you use something like this, you want to gear down. Now, the pinion that they include in the kit is a 16-tooth pinion. So I'm actually going to start off with a 13-tooth pinion, which apparently is the smallest that you can put on this motor mount with the current spur gear. So I'm going to use the 13-tooth. I'm going to see how this runs. Of course, I'll keep an eye on temps and all that sort of thing during the maiden run. I don't think I need to take you through the trouble of kind of opening all this up in front of you, because let's face it, it's a motor, it's an ESC, and you're going to get to see it anyway very, very soon, as soon as I install it. So that's the combo that's going to go in that. For steering, I've gone back to the trusty JX servos that I've been using. This is from the same family of servos that I'm currently using in my Reaper, which was a 46 kilogram. This doesn't need the 46 kilogram. It doesn't call for that. So I went for 32. Which is still excessive for a car this size, but again, I wanted to have plenty of power in the steering. It's a high voltage servo, so it'll run at 7.4 volts, and you know, with over 32 kilograms of torque, and I think 0.12 or no, I think it's 0.09 seconds, according to the specs there. I think that's going to be plenty fast and plenty powerful for this car. I'm going to hook this one up to one of my Futaba radios as well. So I've got just a fairly basic kind of orange receiver that I've used in my Futaba radios in the past, and they've worked fine. So I'll be doing that, and that's pretty much it. So let's get to work and get this guy all fixed up, because I want to be able to run it this weekend and make sure I give you guys a good show over at the BMX track. There we go, all done. That was quick, wasn't it? Well, actually, it really kind of wasn't. This did take a few hours to complete and do the install, but essentially, that's what it all looks like, fully ready to go. And it's kind of funny, like this was totally unintentional, but the servo matches all the electrics and all the sort of like polished edges, you know, the bevel edges everywhere. It matches it perfectly. So it looks really factory. It looks like it's all matching when it kind of really isn't. But yeah, very nice install, if I do say so myself. Now you'll notice that there's not a lot of room here. I mean, that ESC just fits in there, and it's about a millimeter or so away from the motor, and I had to move it as close to the motor as possible, because when you use your steering, you can see there that you don't want the servo horn touching the ESC and you know, creating issues for your servo. So that's why I had to move the ESC as far across as I could. The cables for everything kind of go in through there into the receiver box, and that's how that all worked out. So very nice, very neat, and that's exactly how I like it. Nice short cables everywhere. I did leave the cables here a little bit longer than I'll normally, purely because I'm gonna be running a variety of different batteries in here. It's not gonna be just one type, and I wanted to have flexibility to obviously, you know, have the cables long enough to reach around, and whether I'm gonna have the cables facing this way or facing that way, depending on the batteries that I'm using. That's why I've done it like that. But other than that, yeah, everything works really well. Now, I have done a little bit of a kind of a speed run up and down my street just to make sure everything was working okay. There weren't any funny noises or anything sort of out of place. You know, maybe I would have missed something during the build, but everything worked out very nice. The thing sounds incredible, and I don't know if it's these tires, if it's the motor, or if it's the fact that it's running a plastic spur gear. I don't know what it is, but this car sounds phenomenal when you really wind it up. Speaking of which, there is plenty of power on this in this combo here. Even with just a tiny little 13 tooth pinion, there's heaps of power in this. I'm guesstimating somewhere around the 75 to 80 Ks just on 4S, which is what I've got plugged in here at the moment. I know that this system can run on 6S. I don't know if I'm going to really do it, maybe just for some speed tests. But other than that, I'll probably just run this on 4S because it has a plenty of power. There is no shortage of that, and it's super smooth. I mean, this is my second censored combo. The first one that I had, you know, was a Tekken. This one's the Hobbywing. Honestly, I love censored combos. I really do. And you know, you can have a really good motor and ESC combo that's sensorless, but no matter what, when you plug in a sensored combo, you can feel the smoothness and how nice it actually feels, how responsive it is on the throttle trigger as well. So, highly recommend, you know, if you are going to go for something that's a little bit more quality, something that you know, you're going to be a little bit more proud of, you know, splurge a little bit, get yourself a nice little sensored combo. And if you've never had one, I think you will you'll really enjoy it. I personally really like them, and I'm hoping that I'll get more in the future. So, all the cables and everything that you see on here, the cables coming from the ESC to my battery, and these cables, these are not the cables that came with this combo. I actually had some leftovers from my Max 6 build that I recently did with the Reaper. So all the cables that are included, especially the ones for the motor, motor to the ESC, these are only 12 gauge. I actually used 10 gauge on here, and same with the power cables. I used 10 gauge here, but interestingly, they did have 10 gauge for the power cable. So to go to your battery, they had 10 gauge, but on the motor side, they had 12 gauge. So I just had some leftover cables, and I figured I'd use those, keep these for another project. They do give you two lengths of sensor cable. There's one here that's quite long, and of course I used the short one because I could have even used half of that length, to be honest. But yeah, that's essentially the nice cables that they give you, and of course you get some more Hobbywing stickers, instruction manuals for everything, and an interesting one as well. In case you guys are wondering, I managed to program this ESC with this program card. I've had this since my Blue XC Run 150 amp ESC. I've had to upgrade the firmware on this a couple of times because there's a little USB thingy port just here. But this plugged straight in, connected it up, and I was able to program everything. It tells you what you're programming and what the settings are on screen. If you've never had one of these Hobbywing program cards, get yourself one because they are brilliant, especially with these higher end Hobbywing combos. They work brilliantly. A few extra bits and pieces that came in here. There's also a spare fan that came in the packet with the ESC. Some shrink tubing, double-sided tape, the usual stuff that you get with ESCs and so forth. Nothing interesting about the motor other than the instruction manual. and I think it had those black cables and that was it. Now, finally, for the body, just as we finish up here, I did say that I wasn't going to be spending a lot of time on the body because this is going to be bashed around, it's going to be kicked around quite a bit, and I didn't feel that spending a huge amount of time on this body was really warranted, especially considering that the body feels a little bit thinner than normal, and I just fear that you spend all this time cutting it up and masking it and doing all this, and then only to find that it's all going to get broken up fairly quickly because it's just doesn't seem as thick as some of the others. So I painted up the body. Now I'm going to warn you, this is not my best work. I rushed it. I wasn't quite sure what color scheme I was going for. I had something in mind, but it didn't really turn out the way that I wanted to. So this is not my favorite body by any means, but I'll let you guys kind of decide in the comments whether or not you like it. But essentially, this is the body that I painted up. So it's just plain black, and it's got some of the stickers that were included with it. They're the stickers there, and then you've got this pinstripe that I did. Now this is just a plain red with a camel yellow. And I'll be honest, I wanted the yellow to be more like the yellow that's on this Zeus sign. And it looked like it was going to be close enough on the lid of the spray can, but it looks a little bit more orangey than yellow, to be honest with you. I'm not really super impressed with this color. I would have preferred more this color. I think it would have stood out a little bit more, but you live and learn. Now, I did learn something in doing this, and that was that to do these pinstripes, if you want to know how I did all these pinstripes, because of course it is the same on the other side, in case you're wondering. So I've done the pinstripe kind of going like that, follow the body contours. Now I actually got these tapes from work. Now these are Tamiya tapes. This one here is only like a couple of millimeters, and this is ideal for pinstripes. And same with this one, which is about 6 millimeters. They got another one that's about 10, and that you use that for making like different stripes and so forth. Now this type of tape I've used, like the 18 mil wide one for doing normal masking. I've used this years ago, and it worked fine. Just for doing normal masking, this works fine. And of course, having this smaller one, it gives you that sort of semi-wide stripe that you see there on the car. But what I was really most impressed with was actually this little guy. This is a really special kind of tape, and it sticks incredibly well to the Lexan body. I was actually most impressed with this. And even though I rushed it, peeling it off and everything, because I was really kind of trying to get this finished as soon as possible, because I want to go out and use it tomorrow, in fact, because my day off. I was really, really impressed with how it stuck, and I'm definitely going to be using that smaller pinstripe more in the future. So who knows, there'll be other bodies that you'll see some pinstripes, and that's how I did them. Other than that, I just masked the windows, did some tint, and hey presto, we're ready to rock and roll. And there it is, the finished product, the Zeus from S-Works. Finished, fully assembled, and ready to take on the BMX track on 4S, and possibly, maybe, perhaps on 6S as well. Alright guys, that is it from me. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and I've given you enough information here so you know what to do and what not to do, what to watch out for and so forth when you're building one of these. If you enjoyed this video, you got something out of it, please be sure to hit that like button. If you didn't, hey, hit the thumbs down button. Either way, it helps me out. Don't forget to check out the video description for more information on the car, as well as links to its previous videos, as well, like the unboxing, for example. I'll have links in there to my social media pages as well. And that is pretty much it for now. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll be speaking to you next time.